Instead of giving you a catalogue of atrocities perpetrated by the Russian regime against Ukraine and by extension Europe and the world, I thought it might be more useful to give you an overview of what is still there and why we might miss it if it goes missing.
The buildings that are getting kind of, the most under attack right now, including in Kharkiv, the 1970s and 1980s high-rise residential suburbs where most people live. And they're not buildings which, for the most part, people are going to write architectural dissertations on. They're just the buildings where people live, and they are being flattened in very obvious attacks on civilians.
Exactly how the war will change Ukrainian tastes and exactly how the reconstruction project will look, I'm not ready to predict at this stage, because it could be that the experiences of recent weeks and following months to come, they might bring back a desire to just go back to as pretty a Cossack fairyland as possible. And in fact, reconstruction would go even further than Soviet empire. It would go as far back as essentially Imperial Russian with Cossack flourishes.
All the things that people in their 20s and 30s seem to want to do in Kharkiv or Kiev or Dnipro or Lviv or wherever, was to do very, very lightweight buildings that you could make quickly, that had that kind of lacked pretension, lacked heaviness, and lacked bombast. And I have no idea if they'd be the sort of people that would be given commissions if this ends in one of the less bad ways it can end. But I'd like to think so.